kid probably could have made himself marshal one day. What else is there to say? The marshals learned to pack those shells full of fire. The accused always got a fair shake in Ceylandia. Some used to take the bullhead trial. Survive the trial without taking a scratch, you'd walk away a free man. The bullhead trial taught folks three things. First, good defense is a good offense. Second, gotta always watch your back. Third, ain't no godlike bull up there gonna save you. Smarter ones knew when to just step aside and let things go. Some folks wound up taking the coward's way out. The kid pulls through in fine form. Well, the kid always wanted to compete in the bullhead trial. No use praying to the gods these days. No time for it either. Kid says a little prayer anyway, Couldn't hurt, right? Pith Orchard. Place is a dead end in more ways than one. Folks used to make pilgrimage here to pay their respects to Pith, the bull. Well, the gods are long gone now, and the Orchard Core is long gone too. Seems Pith ain't much of a watchdog. Pith stood for something once. Something real. In time, though, the bull stopped being a symbol and started being decoration. Pith makes a decent scarecrow, at least. Then Pith lights up like a rodeo. Ain't easy punching through his hide. Kid breaks him to bits. Must have been guarding that shrine. So what'll it be? Invoke the gods, or tell them off? Kid decides to press his luck. Well, if the gods are alive, they must be plenty sore. Kid ain't never seen windbags that quick. Maybe old Pith put a scare in him. Kid passes Pith's trial, and he's richer for it. The gods don't care about trinkets, for the kid ain't no god. Kid ain't found a core, but at least he found Zulf's precious shrine. Now we can build a shrine of our own, though I got some alternatives in mind. Zolf doesn't touch the thing. Says the god of commotion is no children's toy. Turn him round and round all you like. Pith's still gonna be ugly. The Ura feared the gods. We turned them into toys, put their faces on our walls. To master the musket, you gotta get rid of the recoil. The Langston River flowed free and wild till the Calamity drank it all up. Maybe all that water just grew wings and flew off. Riverbanks swarming with windbags. They're so bent on finding the core, they hardly notice the kid. Lucky for him, a certain famous ferry barge is still afloat. Send some squirts crying home as she leaves port. Maybe Nelly knows the way to the core. Maybe she can slip right past all the clamor on the coast. Or maybe not. The security skiff pulls up portside. Nelly's just another windbag to those guns. Just then, the windbags notice who she's sailing with. They're pretty steamed about what happened at Cinderbrick. They try to cut her off,